Hello, this is Artem Barsky, co-founder of Dateerium, and today we will talk how to add ataxic data. Overall, it works exactly the same as adding chipsec data, but you need to make sure that you have appropriate pipeline. So first, we will go to the features of the project by clicking at this three-dot menu and going to edit. And we want to make sure that we have attack pipeline attached to the project. So we search for attack. And indeed, we have attack single read pipeline attached to our project. If it's not, we can do it by adding this check mark. We click the back button and going into the project. Samples. And to add a new experiment, we just click the plus button. So here we select the pipeline that we want to use. This is Stream Galore attack sec pipeline. We add experiment short name, and in this case we are going to add again data from our recent paper. So we are going to GEO. Here you can see the experiments. We want to use ataxic data from this series, and we want to take the experiment that is called attack seek activated 5 hours replicate 2. So we go here. This is GSM sample record for experiment. We can click on either SRA link, or sometimes there is no SRA link, so we click on this biosample link. And from here we can go into SRA. And this is what we need. We need this ID number, SRR747, so on. And you can also see that this is a toxic experiment and layout is single read. So let's go back into SciDub. So first we give experiment name. So this will be activated attack and 5 hours. And this is replicate 2. Cells are naive CD4 cells that were activated for 5 hours. We don't need catalog number. So for genome, again, we use the latest human genome. And then we need to attach the data. So the data from GEO. So we put GEO and SRR number. If there is more than one SRR number, then they can be separated by comma. And click attach. Let's look at the advanced parameters of the pipeline. So expected fragment size, we don't need to clip from either end. We don't want, I usually prefer not to remove duplicates, but I prefer to exclude reads that fall on chromosome M, because for attack we are not very much interested, and oftentimes in attack experiments you get a lot of reads from chromosome M. In fact, if you don't want to get many reads, then you should try using Omni attack protocol. It is works much better than the standard. Okay, now let's go back to general tab and we click save sample, and this will start sample processing. Thank you, and in the next step, we will look how to do differential analysis of ataxic data.